Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lady Designer, and we are back with another speed build video of Inama Zoo. And in this episode, we're going to add the West African lion to our zoo. And despite all the previous episodes that we were kind of planning out what we were going to do in this zoo, I changed plans completely. Well, not completely, but I did change some drastic plans. And that is that I am not going to add a gorilla, neither a chimpanzee, also not a mandrill or anything like that. The reason for that is because I was actually looking where I first wanted to start those type of areas. And that would basically be that I would have to change a lot in the area of the giraffe and the elephant. And I was looking around there and enjoying the view and everything because I already detailed everything over there with the tracks and everything. So it looks just so nice that I really didn't want to touch it. I didn't really see any way of like cutting it off into two sections, the Jeep Safari or anything like that. I just wasn't feeling it, and I was just feeling like, you know what, I should just not touch this area and I should just go and continue with the track ride how I was planning the West African lion habitat and the rest of the zoo, as in like the flamingos, and finishing off the area with the zebras and the buffaloes and those kind of animals. So we're definitely not going to add the gorilla and the mandrill, etc. Despite I was saying that I would, I'm very sorry for the people that were really excited for that. But I just don't feel that it's going to fit in the end with the plans I had in general for this zoo. So that also means that we are basically almost finished. Like I just said, we only need to build the flamingo habitat and then finish off the other side of the entrance for the zebra and the warthog and the buffalo and the ostrich, those type of animals, with some really cool waterfall features and stuff. So that is definitely going to be the last episode, which I'm really looking forward to. And in between, we only will have the flamingo habitat, which is going to be on the other side of the entrance. So that is quite exciting, actually, because that means that in 2 episodes, we finish off Inama Zoo, and in 3 episodes, well, the 3rd episode will be a Jeep Safari video of the POV, or at least, what is that going to be, the 3rd one? Because I'm not really sure if I should also do something with a station. So I might do 1 extra episode with a station for the Jeep Safari itself. I'm not entirely sure yet about that. But yeah, I do hope you guys understand why I decided to do this and that you can accept it and just enjoy what the plans still are for Inama Zoo, and that you're happy that we're almost finished. And if you have seen my other videos, I was already telling a little bit about my plans. When I finish off Inama Zoo, we're obviously having a spot free because I'm basically uploading 2 different zoos this week, 2 different zoos on the other week, and that is like basically rotating at the moment. So I think I want to add another zoo or another style zoo when Inama Zoo is finished, and that's probably going to be a more tropical zoo. I think that is definitely one of my favorite themes, or favorite biomes, I should say, of Planet Zoo. So that is something I really am looking forward to once Inama Zoo is finished. And it's not going to be as a koala zoo, like an Indonesian zoo. There are like so many different styles you can go for a tropical zoo. So I'm definitely going to see what kind of style I want to go for this time. Like Mainland Zoo was obviously also a tropical Asian zoo. So it might be a little bit similar to that, but I'm definitely going to try to make something completely different and definitely use a lot of the experience I have from Koala Zoo with different height elevations and stuff. So I am really excited to start something new again, because we already just started Ponte Zoo. So obviously you guys are not missing out on any new zoos. We have a lot of stuff going on right now, but I do really enjoy having this many different types of zoos. And also I do enjoy the feeling that we are now already closing Inamazu, and probably in a few weeks or a few months we're also going to be able to finish off the boat safari rides, and then we're also able to start another zoo again in a completely different style that may be something with the Indian theme, which I haven't touched barely in the game at all, and we have the game now for more than a year, so that is quite interesting. Definitely something I would love to try as well, so yeah. But maybe there is something completely different that, or a different style, or maybe even a pack that will change my mind completely for that. But I think the Tropical Zoo is definitely something I want to touch when Inamazu is finished. So hope you guys enjoyed that. So about the habitat, as you maybe have seen, there is a Jeep Safari Trek going actually in between the hippo habitat and the West African lion habitat. But I wanted to make sure that the West African lion is not able to climb up to the Jeep. So the Jeep is actually going around a habitat, or like one edge of the habitat, and not going through the habitat. So in this case, it's not gonna happen that a lion is in front of the Jeep, because if that would happen, then they would also be able to walk into the hippo habitat and probably also be able to reach the elephants and giraffe habitat. So that is definitely something we want to avoid in this case. So I made sure that there is like this steep slope, I'm not really sure if that is the right word for it, but it's like going vertically down basically from the track ride itself. And you maybe saw me putting down like those flat rock formations, something that probably reminds you of the franchise zoo we did. I really do like that style of using rock, so I did use that for this particular area to make sure that the lions are obviously not able to climb up there or to jump up there. It's definitely deep enough, and the guests definitely have this open view into the habitat itself, so they have a really nice viewing point, in my opinion, into the habitat itself. Talking about franchise mode, for those who are wondering why I haven't uploaded anything yet, I was kind of a little bit burned out of franchise mode. Like, I already spoke about that a little bit during the episode. And all of a sudden, there was supposed to be an update with the multi-select tool of the franchise mode trading center. So then they updated it with the aquatic pack. So I was super happy, and I was cleaning my other zoos, making sure, but like my whole training center was completely full, because I was like, well, multi-select, so I can really easily put them in another habitat and I don't have to select them all one by one. So I had like a full training center with like, I think 49 animals or 50 animals. And then all of a sudden, Frontier decided to reverse that change. So reverse that update. So the multi-select tool for the animals in the training center did not work anymore for franchise mode. And then I had a full franchise training center, and I was just very annoyed about that. And I just raged crit, basically. And I was like, you know what? I'm not even going to continue franchise mode anymore until they have fixed it. And there was an update today. I'm recording this voiceover on the 19th of January, 2021. So today there was an update, and they made it clear that they still haven't fixed the issue with the multi-select tool for franchise mode again. So yeah, it's probably going to take a little longer or anything, but I think it's good to take a little break of franchise mode for myself, and maybe we will start a new franchise mode once we have a new pack or something. That will be fun maybe, and also just to finish off the desert too probably. So yeah, I really hope you guys understand, but sometimes you just need to take a break of some things. Like, it's totally fine if you're getting a little bit burned out, and just find your way of other things that you do enjoy building in or working on. And for me, that is definitely sandbox mode in this case. So yeah, I really do hope that you guys enjoy that for the time being. We're obviously getting back to franchise mode at some point, but I just don't know exactly when. I really do hope that Frontier will be able to fix that pretty soon, and I'm able to clear that whole trading center again. But yeah, we have to wait and see about that. So normally, West African lions live in a more very grassland, more plain habitat. And that was at first a plan for the West African lion. But in the end, I actually changed my mind, and I wanted to make it a little bit more greener and a little bit more lush, because I don't know, I just felt like it looks so beautiful. And we already have like very plain grassland habitat on the other side with the cheetah and the African wild dog, so I wanted to do it a little bit different. This is a more lusher area in Africa where you would see some lions. And obviously, we wanted to make sure that the lions are able to climb a few trees. I do remember, it's been a very long time ago, but I remember that we spoke about lions in Africa and that I saw a documentary about tree climbing lions. And there is like this particular smaller area in Africa where there are lions that live in the trees, which is actually really cool. They really taught themselves to live in the trees with their cubs. It's so fascinating. So I really had that in my mind when I was putting down the trees, like making sure that there would be animals or there will be lions that will be able to live in the trees. Like, obviously they don't do that in Planet Zoo itself, but just for the imagination, obviously. And of course, to really decorate the habitat itself, it was quite easy because I had a lot of blueprints, so I could do a lot of copy-pasting in this case. But I really wanted to use the smaller rocks for like a bigger area in this case, because it's quite a big exhibit. So I really wanted to make sure that I had like these clusters of small little rocks to detail a lot more. And I think it just looks great. It definitely gives that finishing touch to your area, I think, with the small little rocks. So I do really, really love that. And also decorating around the water section itself, a little bit in the water, really to give a more realistic feeling, even though realistically you would probably fill like way more areas with those small little rocks. But I don't know, I just think that it definitely looks really well. And of course, spreading out some enrichment items to make sure that the guests are able to see the lions up close from the Jeep. Like, it's not like a super long experience from the Jeep Safari to look into the lion habitat. So yeah, you want to make sure that the lions will be attracted at some point towards the Jeep Safari track ride. So yeah, that is something I really kept in my mind when putting down the enrichment items for the West African lion. I didn't do too much of terrain work in this case because I really still had in my mind, like, you have a lot of flat land with the grassland area. So even though this is a little bit more lush, like, you don't want to go too crazy with the land, obviously. So yeah, I do hope that you guys enjoyed this new episode of Inama Zoo. As said, we're only two more episodes probably away, at least two more speed builds, maybe three, of finishing off this whole beautiful African wildlife zoo. So that is really awesome. I really hope you guys enjoyed this journey so far. We're not done yet. Do let me know in the comment section down below, of course. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed. Subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And you can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and all other social media pages. So definitely find those links in the description down below. And if you want to support the channel a little extra, you may want to consider to become a FAFM member with the link down in the description. And you may also get some early access to some of my videos. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye, guys!